of the Lord, even the Lord God. You are the one that caused my voice to be heard in the courts of heaven. I that wasn't anything that God would have looked at. God would not have looked at our direction, but the Savior came and brought us closer to him by paying the price for our reconciliation to the Most High God. Give him glory. He deserves all the glory. And please let your voice be heard. Let your voice be heard. In Jesus' name we pray. And when the Savior, the Lord Jesus, finished his ministry on the earth, he handed everything to the Spirit of Truth. And he said he is going to be with us. He's going to be with the church forever and ever. Open your mouth and worship the Spirit of the living God, the Holy Spirit, the teacher, the comforter, the one that convicts the sinner, the Spirit of life. Worship him. Say, Lord Holy Spirit, I thank you. I thank you for giving me life. I thank you for your companionship of the church. I thank you for interpreting the truth to your church. I thank you for comforting in times of distress. I thank you for your presence in this place and your presence forever until Christ returns. Give him glory. Please give him glory. The Spirit of Truth, the executor of the divine will, the one that executes the policeman of heaven, the one that executes the will of the Father on the earth. Give him glory. He is in this place. He is in this place. He is here for you. He is here for his church. He is here because of you. He is here because of me. He is here because of the people that are afar off. And he is in the earth to execute the will of the Most High God. Give him praise. Give him worship. In Jesus' name we pray. That's a bigger amen than that. Psalm 107 verse 15 and 16 says, oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works for the children of men. For he has broken the yokes of brass and set the bars of iron in sunder. It is time to praise the Lord for GCK. GCK, the instrument by which God is reaching the nations 6 days in every month and 12 months a year. Meaning what? 6 days a month times 12 months a year, 72 days out of 365 days. One out of every 5 days, heaven touches the earth through GCK. Can you please raise up your hand and say, God, I thank you for GCK. What that has made it possible for us to be here. Lord, I thank you for the vision you gave to your servant. I thank you for your faithfulness to this vision. I thank you, Lord, because you've made impossibilities possible. I thank you, Lord, for the technical crew, people who have laid their lives down, put their strength and their talent and their everything on the line for the Lord, that the whole earth would hear the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for those who have made their energy available to do physical work, those who have made their resources available to sponsor the gospel, those who have made their energy available to pray and to fast and to preach and to evangelize and to follow up and to work day and night, that this vision would come to fruition. Please lift up your voices and thank the Lord for Global Crusade with Kumuyi. God's vehicle for global evangelization. God's instrument for the illumination of the earth with the light of the kingdom of God in our time. Thank the Lord for this opportunity. Thank the Lord for this glorious opportunity. We are gathered here. People are gathered in America. People are gathered in England. People are gathered in all continents at the same time, listening to the same message, listening to the same Christ, and getting the touch of the living God. Souls have been saved. Miracles, numberless miracles God has performed at various times. Please open your mouth and say, God, I thank you for GCK. I magnify your name. Thank you for the vision you gave. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you for your help. I am a witness that God sends down help anytime there is GCK and makes things that have been thought inconceivable to come to materialization. And that is why you are here also, to have a taste of what people would have thought to be impossible. And this night, you will be surprised. People will be surprised at what God will do in your own life. That is why you should thank him for what he has been doing. him for what he has been doing. Thank him for what he will do this night through this program. And thank the Lord for the convener of GCK. God's microphone for this generation. Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumuyi, the man who at his age, the Lord has strengthened. And every month he is moving from one part of the earth to the other, from one part of the nation to the other, preaching morning and preaching evening and preaching and counseling and doing everything, and he's not tired. And God has kept him healthy, and God has kept him strong, and God has kept him in every realm. And but plus the whole burden of Deeper Christian Life Ministry globally, he is still carrying that, and he's shouldering the tax of global evangelization every month. My brethren, please, would you just lift up your voice and thank the Lord for this kind of a person, for this kind of a gift to our world, for this kind of a gift to the Christendom, for this kind of a gift to this universe at this time. Lift up your voice. Let heaven hear you. It's not a time to be quiet. You know, just like, don't be quiet at all. Open your mouth and let God hear that you are grateful. I am grateful. We ought to be grateful. Even the sinners are grateful. People who are far off are grateful. The nations are grateful. Secular rulers are grateful. Everyone that knows what God is doing at this time is grateful. Thank the Lord also for all of the leaders of churches and denominations, all the leaders of Christendom across denominations who have keyed into the vision and partnership for the interface that God has brought through this program for global salvation. And they have put their all there. They bring their churches, they bring their workers, they bring their everything and say, let us push this vision. And God has made it a rallying point for cooperation among denominations. Thank the Lord for all of those from all those denominations, and ask the Lord God and say, expand the horizon of their work also. Expand your call and your commission in their lives also. Until from coast to coast, from shore to shore, the light of the gospel will cover the earth. Thank the Lord for this precious opportunity that you have. Thank the Lord for those he has saved in the past GCKs, those he has restored, those he has healed, those he has sanctified, those he has delivered, the yokes he has broken, the captives he has set free. Bless the name of the living God. In Jesus' name we pray. I want to hear a global amen. In Psalm 145 verse 10, the word of God says, all thy works shall praise thee, O Lord, and thy saints shall bless thee. Thy kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and thy dominion endureth throughout all generations. Psalm 146 verse 10 says, the Lord shall reign forever and ever. Even thy God, O Zion, unto all generations. And the church says, and the children of God said, and Daniel chapter 7 verse 13, 14 says, and I saw in the night visions, and behold, one like the Son of Man came with the clouds of heaven and came to the Ancient of Days, and that was giving him dominion and glory and a kingdom that all people and nations and languages should serve him, and his dominion is an everlasting dominion which shall not pass away, and his kingdom that which shall not be destroyed. And it just says, that is the decree of the Most High God, that at this time the everlasting kingdom of the everlasting King should be established, and it should reign from shore to shore, from age to age. It is time to crown the King of Kings. It is time to set a throne for him, beginning from your own life, to your family, to your church, to your community, to your tribe, to your state, to your nation, to your continent. Please start with yourself. Say, God, oh thou that created my soul and everything visible and invisible, Lord, I erect a throne for you to reign without rival in my heart. Reign without rival in my heart. Reign without termination of tenure in my life. Please open your mouth and pray. This is the most important aspect, that you prepare yourself for what God is going to do in your life this night. God does not take what is not given to him. He takes what is given to him. It is the enemy that tries to take what is not given to him. And so if you do not give yourself to him, he will bypass you. But God forbid that God will bypass you this night. Say, oh God of glory, you deserve a throne, and the throne should be in my heart. Reign in me without rival. Reign in my family without rival. Reign in my children without rival. Reign in my spouse without rival. And anything that contests your rulership, Lord, I reject them. I disown them. And I say they must be submitted for subjugation, for elimination, for destruction. And no matter how precious they seem to be to my flesh, no matter how precious they seem to be to my life, Lord, whatsoever opposes you, whatsoever diminishes your glory in my life, whatsoever obscures my view of your fullness, whatsoever tries to hinder the manifestation of your fullness in my life, God, I disown it. God, I reject it. Oh God, I submit it to you for destruction, for elimination, that you will reign without rival in my life. Let heaven hear you. This is important, that the Lord God of glory, the one that rules the earth, will rule my life. He will rule my heart. He will rule my spirit. He will rule my soul. Say, oh God, I submit my spirit, my soul, and my body to you this day. Reign without rival. In Jesus' name we pray. A bigger amen. And you are going to tell the Lord, God, my community, my state, my nation, God, you must reign. Whatsoever opposes your rulership, Lord, must be brought down this day. Open your mouth and pass it as a decree. Tell the Lord and say, God, as you reign in my life, you will reign in my community, in my state, in my nation. It doesn't matter what the enemy claims. What does the word of God say? He said, declare unto them that all of these things that created, they didn't create the heavens and the earth, all the powers, all the gods that under these heavens that never created the heavens and the earth, they shall perish. They shall famish from under these heavens, because the Lord is God, and he is God alone. Besides him, there is no God. Before him, there is none. After him, there shall be none. Say, Lord, you will reign. In Nigeria, you will reign. The work of your hand cannot oppose you. The work of your hand cannot oppose you. The things that you formed and made with your own hand cannot stop your purpose in this nation. The things that you created cannot stop the Creator. Please, brethren, open your mouth and declare it. And the Lord will use your word to do his purpose. And then the light of the gospel will cross to your nation. Every nation that a door has been erected by the enemies of the light, that door must be broken. That door must be broken. That door must be broken. Even this day, in the name of Jesus, the church of God said, Psalm 22 verse 28 says, for the kingdom is the Lord's, and he is the governor among the nations. He is the governor among the nations. Can you hear? Can you say, my God is the governor among the nations? Say it. I want you to declare it emphatically. My God is the governor among the nations. Put your own country there. My God is the governor in Nigeria. It is so in Jesus' name. Psalm 79 verse 9, 10 and 11 says, verse 9 says, help us, O God, of our salvation, for the glory of thy name, and deliver us and purge away our sins for thy name's sake. Wherefore should the heathen say, where is their God? Let the sign of the prisoner come before thee, according to the greatness of thy power. Preserve them that are appointed to die. You see, in this prayer here, those who are in the chains of sin, those who are in the chains of the oppression of the devil, and those who are in chains of terminal diseases, appointed to die. that God will remember all of them this night. You say, oh God, for your holy name's sake, every chain of sin this night, break them. Lord, break them. The one in the church, break them. The invitee, Lord, coming with chain of sin, break them. The newcomer coming with chain of sin, break them. Those who will hear over the microphone, over the home speaker, anywhere they are, oh God, don't spare any yoke of sin. Open your mouth and pray. Say, God, this is a night of salvation. If you open your mouth and ask it, God will do it. What you ask, God will do. The people you are praying for are on the way, and you're also praying for yourself. Say, God, this night, let it be the night of salvation. Purge away iniquity, because provision was made for it. When the Savior bled, for without the shedding of blood is no remission. And that is why he died such a painful death. And the whole blood was drained. Painfully he bled until there was no more blood to bleed. That there might be a fountain open for transgression, that the souls of men may be cleansed. If the sacrifice was perfect and had been made already, then why would one sinner go with a sin stain? Say, God, let not one sinner go with a sin stain from your presence this night, oh God, for your holy name's sake. Open your mouth and tell the Lord and he will do it. God, for your holy name's sake, let not any sinner go from your presence with the stain of sin this night. In Jesus' name we pray. A big amen. You say, wherefore should those who don't know God say, where is their God? There are some people who will be brought from hospitals and they will say, I want to go to GCK. And the doctor will say, do you believe that if you go there, you have anything? The man said, I believe. And they will carry the man in some wheelchair, carry the man in some vehicle, carry the man, and the mockers will be mocking. And the unbelievers will be saying, let us see what will happen. Say, God, for your holy name's sake, let not the wicked say, where is their God? They took them there sick, they are bringing them back sick. They took them there in pain, they are bringing them back in pain. Say, God, let not the heathen say, where is their God? And there are some who are here who have been carrying problems, carrying burdens, carrying afflictions, and the unbelievers are saying, Shebi, you people say there is a big God. Why are you also complaining? Tomorrow you are sick in your leg, the next day you are sick in your head, the next day you are sick in your this, the next day you are talking to your child, the next day you are talking to your mother. Oh God, make a difference between Goshen and Egypt. Even this night, oh Lord, will somebody pray? Will somebody open your mouth and talk to the Lord? God, put a difference between Egypt and Goshen this night, that the heathen will not say, where is their God? Those who come here struggling to come because of pain, let them not be struggling to go back home also. Let them walk on their own. Those who came with aid, somebody struggling, helping them to come, let them go alone on their own and be able to say, I trusted the Lord and he did not put me to shame. For those that put their trust in him will not, cannot, have never before been put to shame. Say, oh God, this night, for your holy name's sake, let not the heathen say, where is their God? In Jesus' name we pray. Let the sign of the prisoners come before thee. Remember the affliction of those that are appointed to die. When the enemy puts an affliction on somebody and the doctor says, this thing has no cure, the doctor says, go home and prepare to die. Medical science says, we cannot do anything about it at all. Those people are appointed to die. But Jesus came and brought Lazarus from the grave after 4 days. He has the power to turn back even the death that took place and cancel it. This night, all of those whom the devil has given death sentence, this night, the sentence must be canceled. Where are you? Are we in agreement? All of those appointed to die, all of those on the death row of the powers of darkness, this night, the King of life, the source of life, the God of life will bring life unto them. Open your mouth and say, oh God, this night, all of those on death sentence, all of those on death row, all of those on terminal diseases, Lord, change their story. Change their story, your own story, your mother's story, your child's story, your neighbor's story, your invitee story, your convert story this night, oh Lord. Change the story. All of those who have been appointed to die, remember their groanings. Some don't sleep in the night. Some if people lie down by 10 p.m. and wake up by 6 a.m., they will stay awake every night. They are crying. They are They are rolling from one side of the bed to the other. They are weeping. When will it end? If not this night. When will it end? If the Most High God will not do it, who will do it? And said, so the harvest is passing, and the summer is ended, and they came day one, and they came day two, and they came day three, and they came day four, and they are coming day five. Here is day six. Oh God, the whole of creation was finished in 6 days. And on the seventh day, God rested. God, whatever has not been done in day one, whatever remained from day two, whatever remained from day three, who is talking, who is praying, who is telling the Lord? God, remember, in 6 days you did everything. Today is day six. Finish every unfinished work, oh God. Finish every unfinished work this night, oh God, and we will magnify your great name. In Jesus' name we pray. Can somebody give heaven a big amen? In Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 11, thus shall you say unto them, the gods that have not made the heaven and the earth, even they shall perish from the earth and from under this heaven. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4 and 5, it says, weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God, to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations, and every thought that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. Every stronghold that exalts itself against salvation, against the will of God, against the glory of God. All the things that said they are God, and they never created human beings. They never created the sea. They said they are God in the sea. They never created the air. They call themselves God in the air. Say, oh God, this night, make it a night of judgment against them. For it is written, I will pass through Egypt, and I will judge the gods of Egypt. I will pass through Egypt, and I will judge their gods. I will judge their gods. Say, oh God, let the angels of judgment bring judgment in the air, judgment on the land, judgment in the sea, judgment in the recesses of darkness. And the people who have gathered to congregate against the God of heaven and earth, they shall be put to shame. For it is written, woe unto him that strives with his maker. Woe unto him. Today is day five. Today is the five. The Lord will do his work this day. He will do his work this day. Everything that exalts itself against the knowledge of God and sets up strongholds of resistance to the light, resistance to the truth, and makes people to be listening to the gospel and they are not touched. Listening to the gospel and they are not transformed. Listening to the gospel and they are not connected to that gospel. God, this day, break every yoke of darkness. The Lord will break every yoke of darkness. He will break every yoke of darkness. It is done in Jesus' name. Somebody has said it is done in Jesus' name. We're going to pray for the word of God and for the minister of the living God, the instrument of the living God. See what the Lord says in Isaiah chapter 55, verse 11. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that to which I please. It shall prosper in the thing which I send it. You say, oh God, put your word in the mouth of your servant. As it is written, open your mouth wide and I will fill it. And God, follow your word, monitor your word, no man will drop to the ground. When he says you are saved, salvation will flow. When he says you are healed, healing will flow. When he says rise up and walk, the bones will receive strength. Say, God, confirm every one of your word this night. Just raise up your hand and say, God, we look up to you. As you have chosen this global instrument, put your word in his mouth and confirm your word that passes through his mouth, that no word will drop to the ground this night. Every soul will be touched. Do you know what the Lord says? Jesus said, the letter profits nothing. He said, but the words I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. He said, yes, he said, he sent his word and healed them. The word that comes from his mouth of his servant, there will be spirit. For it is written, and the spirit moved upon the face of the waters, and God said, let there be light. The word brought light. And God said, let there be light. The word brought light. This night, God will say, the yoke of sin is broken, and the yoke shall be broken. This night, God will say through his servant, the yoke of transgression is taken away. The infirmity is taken away. Lameness is taken away. Blind eye open, and the spirit of God will follow that word and accomplish it. You will not escape the word. I will not escape the word. Those on the way will not escape the word. It's a glorious night. A wonderful night. It is done. It is done. If you believe it is done, can heaven hear your amen? Just lift up your hand and give glory to the living God. And say, God, thank you for the salvation. Thank you for healing. Thank you for deliverances. Thank you for restoration. Thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for a marvelous night. Thank you for GCK, Lord. Thank you for your servant. Thank you for the privilege that I have to witness your work. For Jesus said, blessed are those that see these things. Because been many prophets, people in the past have waited that they will see something like this. They didn't see it. Blessed are your eyes that you see these things. So God, you will do something that we will tell our children, and our children will tell their children. We will tell our children will tell their children about what God can do, because he's unchangeable, the great and mighty God. Lift up your hand and bless his name, because it is done. In Jesus' name we pray. Who is ready for something this night? Can heaven hear your amen? In Jesus' name we pray. Glory be to your name, O Lord God of hosts, Ancient of Days, the God of impossibilities, the one who does mighty things through feeble instruments, the one to whom, Lord, you speak those things that be not as though they were, and then they come into existence. This night, Lord, you will create something out of nothing. Lord, this night you will create health out of infirmities. This night you will create holiness out of the pit of filthiness. In the souls of men, in Jesus' name. Unto you be glory, adoration, dominion, majesty, and praise throughout all eternity. For we pray and believe in Jesus' name. Amen. And the church of God say,
to the Lord forever. clap offering to Jesus. We can do better.
Praise the Lord, my spirit, soul, and body. Praise the Lord, my spirit, soul, and body. Praise the Lord, my spirit, soul, and body. Shout hallelujah, hallelujah.
Anywhere he went, he was doing good.
Almighty healer, healed the leper. When the crippled saw him, they started walking. Even tonight, our Lord did to us good, to us good.
Anywhere he went, he was doing good. Almighty healer, healed the leper. People saw him, they started walking. Even tonight, and God he to us good. Anywhere he went, he was doing good. Almighty healer, he healed the leper. When the people saw him, they started walking. Even tonight, and God he to us good.
Even tonight,
and God he to us good.
And the walls of Jericho in our lives will fall down. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now we're going to shout the hallelujah one more time. And the walls of Jericho in your life will fall tonight. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah,
Tonight, the Holy Ghost will fight your battle. Tonight, you will have victory. Tonight, you will prevail. If you prevail, can I hear your amen? Let's turn our Bibles to 1 Samuel chapter 17. 1 Samuel chapter 17 in verse 50. The Bible says there, so David prevailed. And who will prevail tonight? Can I hear your name? Mention your name again. Now you put your name there. And so Pius prevailed over the Philistine with a sling and with a stone and smote the Philistine and slew him, but there was no sword in the hand of David. David prevailed. Today, you will prevail over the Goliath confronting your life, your family, your career, your health, your ministry in Jesus' name. I don't care to know how long the Goliath has harassed and tormented you. For the Israelites, it was 40 days. Maybe your own has lingered for 40 years, 40 months, 40 weeks, 40 days. Today is your day of victory. Who is that person that will prevail? Let's rise up as we pray together now to say, Lord, I've come this day to plead with you. Let the Holy Ghost fight my battle. I want to prevail over this, over this, over this, and tonight you will prevail. Father, we come to you because you're a great God. We come because you change it not. We come because your promises are yea and amen. We come because we are not partial. You helped David to prevail over Goliath, and tonight your sons and daughters are here. Lord God, whatever Goliath, whatever challenge, whatever difficulty that have been confronting us, hindering us from enjoying what you are giving to us tonight, give us victory over them in Jesus' name. Let the Holy Ghost fight our battles, and let victory be ours. Lord, we commit all the aspect of the program into your mighty hand. Take absolute control. From this moment to the last, amen, be in charge. That at the end, Lord, only you and you alone be glorified. We thank you because you've answered our prayers. For in Jesus' holy name, we are praying. We're going to sing from our program booklet, page 2, I Must Tell Jesus. I must tell Jesus all of my trials. I cannot bear these burdens alone. In my distress, he kindly will help me. He ever loves and cares for his own. I must tell Jesus all of my troubles. He is a kind, compassionate friend. If I but ask him, he will deliver, make of my troubles quickly an end. Tempted and tried, I need a great Savior, one who can help my burdens to bear. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus. He, all my cares and sorrows we share. Oh, how the world to evil allures me. Oh, how my heart is tempted to sin. I must tell Jesus, and he will help me over the world the victory to win. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus. I cannot bear my burdens alone. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus. Jesus can help me. Jesus alone.
go to God in prayer for the nations. First, we want to praise God for all he has been doing for us as we have been holding these crusades. 1 Samuel chapter 7, verse 12. Then Samuel took a stone and set it between Mizpah and Shechem, and called the name of it Ebenezer, saying, "Hitherto has the Lord helped us." Let us therefore appreciate God, for thus far he has helped us in holding his global crusades. Let's thank the Lord. Thus far he has helped us in this current one. This is the fifth day of this crusade this month. Let's thank the Lord for great things he has done. Let's thank God for miracles he has performed. Let's thank God for the healings, for salvation of souls that he has done in the course of this crusade. And let us specifically thank the Lord for our Father in the Lord, the way he has been using him. Let's thank God for Pastor Dr. W. Kumuyi, that God has been using for this crusade. Let's appreciate God for great and mighty things that he has been doing. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Give me a global amen. Amen. Next, the Lord commands that this gospel shall be preached in all nations. Mark chapter 16, verse 15. And he said unto them, "Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature." The Lord commands you must preach to every creature everywhere in the world. Let's therefore pray that the gospel of Christ will prosper in everywhere in the world. That this gospel of the Lord Jesus will prosper in every land. Every resistance to the gospel anywhere in the world, that God should destroy it. Let's pray that GCK's impact will be felt around the globe as we hold this GCK from time to time, from month to month. Let's pray the impact will be felt everywhere around the globe. Souls are being saved. Lives will be changed. Miracles will be performed. Wonders will be performed. We're going to pray also that God will raise up visionary leaders, visionary preachers around the world to preach the gospel. Let's pray God will raise up men and women, visionary women and men, to preach the gospel of Christ around the world. And we are going to pray that anything in the spread of the gospel be taken out of the way. Let's cancel everything that has been standing against preaching the gospel around the world. The laws of the nations, the decrees of the nations, the evil practices in the nations. Let's pray God will take them out of the way, so that the gospel of Christ will be able to spread everywhere around the globe. Our God can do it. And our God will do it. That this gospel will not be hindered anywhere within the globe. Souls will be saved. The gospel will be freely preached. And lives will be changed. We are going to pray that all Christians will be bold enough to declare the gospel everywhere. Brethren, let's pray. All Christians around the world will be bold enough to declare the gospel around the globe. Let's pray for strength for everyone. for grace for everyone to preach the gospel unhindered around the globe. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please give me a global amen. Amen. We're going to pray for nations that still have iron curtains, that God will break all these barriers. All those nations where the gospel cannot be fully preached at the moment, let's pray that God will break down all the barriers. 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9. For a great door and effectual is open unto me, and there are many adversaries. We're going to pray that God will subdue all the adversaries of the gospel. Pray that God will subdue all the adversaries of the gospel. We're going to pray also that the gospel will have an inroad into spiritually difficult places in the world. There are places in the world that the gospel cannot be fully preached. We're going to pray that this gospel of Christ will have an inroad into spiritually difficult places of the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Next, we are going to pray and we will destroy all the power of darkness, keeping people in perpetual ignorance and bondage. Brethren, pray that God will destroy all the powers of darkness, keeping people in perpetual ignorance and bondage. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. We will pray for worldwide revival that will speak souls into God's kingdom. Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 2. O Lord, I have asked thy speech and was afraid. O Lord, revive thy word in the midst of the years. The midst of the years made known. In wrath, remember mercy. Let therefore pray that God will give us a worldwide revival. And God can do it as it happens in the times of old. He's able to do it today. That God will give us a worldwide revival. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Give me a global amen. Amen. We pray for our general superintendent, Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumuyi, and other ministers of the gospel. Let us ask for them, for the dew of heaven, for protection, for fresh anointing, for enlarged vision, for unction to function, abiding grace and direction. Let's pray for them. For anointing, fresh anointing, protection, the dew of heaven, enlarged vision, unction to function, abiding grace and direction. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. I want you to pray for yourself and other participants of this crusade, that God will save souls, that God will perform extraordinary miracles in your own life and in the life of others. Pray for God's blessing to come upon your life as you attend this crusade today. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Thank you, our Father, because you have answered us. We're praying that you give us global revival all around the world, and that this day you use our Father and the Lord to minister life to us. And today, as we hear the word of God, our life will change. Things will turn around in our life. Save souls today, transform lives today. Thank you, our Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, and God bless you.
Amen. I didn't hear your amen. If you are happy, let me hear your amen. This is day 5 of this Prevailing Prayers Global Crusade. And this crusade will be concluded tomorrow, Tuesday, 27th February 2024, at 5 p.m. Nigerian time, which is 16 hours GMT. Please, tomorrow. Everybody say tomorrow. You didn't say it well. Tomorrow will be great. So invite your friends, invite your neighbors, invite your well-wishers, invite your family members, because tomorrow the Lord will not pass you by. The same tomorrow, the last lap of the ministers through professional conference will take place at 8 a.m. Nigerian time, which is 7 hours GMT. Today's conference was awesome. Ministers and ministries were transformed. And Elijahs, many Elijahs were raised up. If you miss today's hold, please don't miss tomorrow's hold. Tomorrow's conference will be remarkable. Do you know why? There will be transfer of power and anointing. Tomorrow, I will get double portion. I didn't hear you well. And if you'll be coming tomorrow, which I know you will come, don't come alone. If you know of any pastor, do that pastor good. And invite the pastor to come tomorrow. Then if you're a pastor, you're a duo, bring all your pastors, bring all your workers, so that they will be on the same page with you. Because when you get the fire and they get the fire, something will happen in your church. So tomorrow, don't come alone. Anybody who is a Christian worker, you know, tell that person, don't miss tomorrow's minister's conference. Then professionals, tell them, don't miss tomorrow's minister's professional conference. Do you know why? Tomorrow, you will receive the power to stay faithful amid end time ministry challenges. There are many challenges. This time, we need the power to skate through. And tomorrow, you get that power. The program we hold at Obiwan International Conference Center, Port Harcourt. So tomorrow, please be there. There will also be lunch hour with Jesus, the same tomorrow, for all the converts of this crusade at 3 p.m. at hall 7 of the church auditorium. So please, if you gave your life to Christ on the first day, Thursday, Friday, Saturday during the impact, or Saturday during the crusade, and yesterday, Sunday's worship service, or Sunday evening crusade, and today, please, be there tomorrow, because the Lord has a package of blessing for you, for you, for you. Now, we want to recognize some of the dignitaries in our midst. First we have here is His Royal Highness, Eze Nyema Onuwo JP. Inyeri Simbam Nyewel Oporotoma Obiakpo local government. You didn't clap very well. Wise kings still seek Jesus. And I know that His Royal Highness will not live here the same. So if you have testimony, please go to my left. Just this tent there. The brethren are waiting for you. Now I want to welcome everyone. I want to welcome you specially because you are special. Are you special? If you are special, say amen. And I also want to inform you that God is here. Do you believe that? Do you believe that? Let me tell you this. He is present to present presence to those who are present in His presence. And today, you will receive a present. if you remain in his presence. Some people rush out from the presence of God, maybe before the message, or during the message, or immediately after the message. Some also rush out during the prayer session, or immediately after the prayer session. Some rush out during the praise worship after the prayers. Some also rush out during testimonies. They miss a lot. But if you can remain in God's presence, he will give you complete presence. All that he has for you, you will get. You had the testimony of one of the participants. She said, when she came here, she had challenges, problems, but she remained in God's presence. She will stay here from beginning to the end, and she said God worked in her. She felt the arrangement going on from her head to her spine to her toe. God arranged everything in her life. But if you rush out from the presence of God, you prevent God from arranging all the things you need to put in order in your life. For me, I will remain in God's presence until they say the last amen. All the things God has for me in the message, in the prayer session, during the worship, in the testimony time, I will get all. Will you get all? If you get all, let me hear you say, I will get all. So shall it be to you in Jesus' name.
We now bring you choir ministrations from regions, states, and nations across the world.
Yeah. So long I searched for life's meaning, enslaved by the world and my greed. Then the door of my prison was opened by love, for the ransom was paid, I was free. Guilt that I carry, from the dull, empty life I'm set free. For when I met Jesus, he made me complete. He forgot the foolish child I used to be.
I'm free. If you are free, say it now. I am free. Testimony time. GCK is a fulfillment of the Great Commission, because GCK is gospel to every creature and to every nation. And the Lord has been confirming the word of his servant with signs and wonders. This evening, you hear some of the signs and wonders. Let's listen to the first testifier.
Praise the Lord. My name is Dr. John Dixon, a medical personnel. God has been doing great things in our GCK. Tonight, we're going to hear some of the wonders that the Lord has done. Beside me is Mrs. Dorcas Egelima. She will share her testimony.
Children of God, praise the Lord. Children of God, praise Master Jesus. My name is Mrs. Dorcas Egelima. I'm from Choba Old Group. And my testimony is in the area of giving. I just want to give this testimony to the glory of the God of GCK, the God of unlimited blessings, and the God of multiplication. My testimony goes like this. Last year, I sowed into the GCK June 2023. I thought I sowed my best seed unto God, not knowing it wasn't my best. During the prayer meeting, one of the prayer meetings held under this canopy here, one of our senior pastors made mention of his own personal experience in the area of giving. Immediately he finished saying it, I had a ministration in my heart that God wanted me to go and review the amount I sold. I sold a certain amount, thinking it was the best. Meanwhile, in my account, I still had far, far, far more than what I sold. Immediately, the senior pastor said what he said, and God ministered to my heart. I can remember I was crying. I knew it was God talking to me. Immediately, the next day, I went to my account and emptied my account and paid it into the GCK. My brothers and sisters, I want to tell us, weeks after, I got an alert from an unexpected source about 6 to 7 times, nearly 7 times the amount I sold. Praise God. My brothers and sisters, I want to tell us, when we key into the vision of GCK and the man of God, this God of heaven will bless us, nyafu nyafu, in Jesus' name.
Nyafu nyafu, blessing is coming. Who will be the next? But let me tell you, they said givers never lack. But those who are stingy, poverty is their portion. I will not be stingy. Will you be stingy? Some have not given for GCK, some not giving for church work, some have not done anything. Today, you are challenged. If you want nyafu nyafu blessing, give. The next testifier.
Praise the Lord. More wonders. The person by my side is Mrs. Ilami Kibui. She has a wonderful testimony of what God has done. Let's hear her.
My dear brothers, praise the Lord. The Lord has done so much for me. The Lord keep me alive. As the Bible said, that let the living praise the Lord. And my name is Ilami Kikboye. I'm in the old town group, NPA district. Year before last October, I felt sick over 2 months. So my senior sister, they took me to private clinic where I used to deliver my children. And they treated me. They tested me. They said it's malaria and typhoid. And they treated me. There was no help from there. And they took me home to my mother's place. They said that my mother should take care of me very well. So I was there with my mother, and I heard that our dad is coming in Port Harcourt. Port Harcourt sent buses to Abuja. So I joined the free buses down to Port Harcourt. And I came here. I don't even reach my house in Port Harcourt. I just came here straight. And I stayed here with my dreams. And God helped me. After the crusade, God delivered me. God saved me. I cannot speak well, but today I can speak. I am healed till today, and the Lord is providing for me and my husband in Jesus' name. God have moved me from one room and enlarged my coat in Jesus' name. I thank God for everything. It's all the glory and honor to the Almighty God in Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise the Lord. She had an undiagnosed illness that affected her voice. She was dribbling saliva from her mouth. But after the prayer of the man of God, she was healed. Praise the Lord.
Put your hand together for Jesus. We'll go online now because this is a global crusade. The miracle is global, everywhere. Okay, the next testifier.
Praise the Lord. We still have more to hear of what God has done. Beside me is Mrs. Joy, God's power. She's here to testify of the goodness of the Lord. Let's hear her.
Let them praise the Lord. The Lord is good.
Sister Joy God's power. I come from the Ikure region. I'm here to testify the goodness of God. First of all, God, what God did for me in the last year, in the Emmanuel, December Emmanuel edition. I was having problem with my left ear. I don't know how the thing came about. I just woke up one morning. I saw my ear. I was having a lot of noise in my ear, left ear. I was saying, what is this? What will it be? I slept peacefully. I woke up. I begin to hear this kind of noise. I will carry the cutting board. I will check. I will not see anything. Thing keep on disturbing me. I will be like, sometimes it will be like something will be coming out. It's coming out for ear. I will put cutting board. I will not see anything. Thing keep on troubling me. Till the day GCK, I believe God because I'm not somebody that moved to go to America this year to give me a drug. So I just have faith that God will do it for me. So that Emmanuel edition, when our general hospital was praying, he said we should raise a hand up and put ear. I carry my finger, put in that ear. As he was praying, I felt something move out of my ear, and that is the end of that ear noise. Till today, I did not hear that kind of noise again. Amen. Second one, I want to thank God for the fire incident, how God delivered my husband. That was first of this February, that Thursday. My husband, God, I cannot go narrating how the things that happened, but I really thank God for that thing happened at midnight. Nowhere to run out. He cannot go to anywhere to say we are going to look for anything. But at midnight, I cried to God. I was asking for mercy. And God delivered him. Because many people passed through that thing and passed away. But God did totally deliver him. I said, God, who has done all these things to me? May glory return to him in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. The madam who just gave her testimony had about 3 weeks of tinnitus on her left ear, that's hearing sound in the ear. But after the prayer of the man of God, she was healed. Praise the Lord.
Tell it on the mountains, over the hills, and everywhere that God is still performing wonders. Where there are prevailing prayers, miracles abound. Friends, we can't keep silent. We must share them with you. Listen and be blessed.
John Eo testifies from Ogubolo Rivers. Praise the Lord. I never believed in God or church, but after I encountered the pastor and started coming to Deeper Life Bible Church and attending GCK programs, I discovered that the swollen legs were dried up after the prayers of the man of God. The Lord has healed me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Testimonies from Ogubolo are a festival of miracles. From Ogubolo, Benjamin, a first timer wrote, praise the Lord, I've been having financial challenges, but after the program, my debtor walked up to me and paid me. Praise the Lord.
We now return to the moderating overseer.
Alpha Location Choir.